Do you feel that large language models like ChatGPT are the one-size-fits-all solution to all of your business problems? Are you still more on the fence about whether you should adopt large language models as part of your processes? Hi, my name is Dr. Jodie Burchell, and I've been working in data science and natural language processing for many years. In fact, I was working with some of the earliest large language models when they first became available. In this video, I'm going to be offering a different perspective on using LLMs, and I'm going to be cutting through the hype to help you decide whether your business really needs to be using them. We'll first briefly talk about what LLMs are and what they're good and bad at. We'll then go over some of the challenges of using these models in production. We'll end by discussing whether a large language model is really the best choice for your business problem, whether you can get away with using something simpler and cheaper. LLMs are general-purpose language models that are capable of doing a range of tasks that you might need to do with natural language, that is, languages like English, Spanish, or Mandarin. Under the hood, they are a type of model called a neural network, and more specifically, a type of neural network called a transformer model. The type of LLMs that are getting the most attention at the moment are those that are capable of generating text. The reason they can do this is because they're asked to predict the next word in a sentence during their training. These models are trained over petabytes of text data. To give you an idea of how much data that is, one petabyte contains 166 million copies of the complete works of Shakespeare. Now that's a lot of text. So unsurprisingly, LLMs tend to encode a lot of information about how language works as part of their training. Large language models are, well, language models. So they're really good at solving problems in this domain. This includes things like, of course, generating text, but it can also include things like text classification, summarization, or translation. It can also include some limited problem solving with text. So what can't LLMs do? Well, they're not so great at solving problems that are rule-based, such as those that involve maths or logic. For example, let's see what happens when we try to get ChatGPT to solve a simple arithmetic problem. In order to be able to successfully solve this, ChatGPT would have needed to see enough identical problems in its training set. Because it hasn't, it can't solve the problem and it just hallucinates something that looks close enough. In addition, while these models can encode information as part of their training, they don't always produce the most reliable information. One reason that you can't rely on the information produced by large language models is their well-documented tendency to hallucinate. That is, when an LLM doesn't have internal knowledge about something, it will just invent a plausible-sounding but completely false answer. The other reason is due to how incredibly expensive it is to train these models, which makes it really hard to update the knowledge that they've encoded. This means that as these models age, the knowledge that they have becomes increasingly out of date. One other consideration when using large language models is that they're large. In fact, these models are so big that they require gigs of GPU memory just to run them. And this doesn't come cheap. In addition, how well these models perform is dictated almost entirely by how big the model is and how much data it's trained on. This means if you need very accurate or sophisticated predictions from a large language model, you may need to use cloud machines that cost in the range of dollars per hour to run these models. While there are ways to reduce the size of these models while still preserving a lot of their performance, a process known as quantization, the largest of the LLMs are still going to be quite big after this, and they're still going to require significant and expensive computing resources. In addition, due to the difficulty of getting LLMs to reliably produce accurate answers, it can be hard to get good performance from these models out of the box. One solution is to use a technique called retrieval augmented generation, which gives LLMs access to information which is relevant to your problem domain. Now, naturally, the problem with this is that it adds a complicated step to what might already be a complicated LLM pipeline. And with salaries for ML and ML ops engineers averaging from $100 to $150,000 per annum in the United States, it may be a significant outlay to hire the people who can actually build and maintain your LLM system. So this leads to the final question. Does your business problem need a large language model? Well, if it's not a natural language problem, then the answer is no. As we've already talked about, large language models are poor at doing problems that involve rules. In the case of such problems, you're better off using heuristics or maybe another type of machine learning model. And what if your problem is a natural language problem? Do you need an LLM then? Well, the answer is maybe. Large language models have the advantage of being able to solve many natural language problems with just one model. But as we've seen in this video, they have many downsides as well. There are many approaches to trying to process text, and depending on your problem, you may be able to use something much less complex. For more straightforward problems, you may be able to get away with using older and simpler techniques. For example, you can represent your text using techniques such as binary or count vectorization, or maybe use document embeddings using models such as Word2Vec or Doc2Vec. These approaches can be appropriate when you're solving one specific problem, say text classification, or maybe when you have really high quality training data. You can also use smaller large language models and use a process called fine tuning to adapt them to your specific problem. Early large language models, such as say DistilBERT, can still give really good performance at a fraction of the size, expense, and difficulty to run of current large language models. LLMs are best reserved for complex natural language processing tasks, such as text summarization, customer support interfaces, and of course, solving problems using code. At JetBrains, we have our own code assistance products powered by large language models. If you're interested in seeing how LLMs can help data scientists and developers be more productive with coding, check out our AI assistant in either Data Law team or in our IDEs. While there is a tendency to be dazzled by these models, I hope this video has shown you that LLMs have a very specific use case, and they're definitely not a magic bullet for all business problems.